Baylor burns a timeout after having scored in the first overtime. The Aggies have opened the overtime by scoring. And they got it in on a 16-yard run by Joseph. Baylor then has scored on a 12-yard pass to Ziegler. They're going for two.
No kicker.
Well, they sure are.
Let's see if the Aggies will take their timeout to adjust to what Baylor's going to do. They have one left.
They're going for two. They're trying to win it at home in overtime. Three wides to the left, two to the right. Empty in the backfield. Bell waiting on the snap. Going for two. He's got it. He's looking. He's still looking. He's throwing. And it is caught. It's good. Baylor wins.
Trying to tear down the goalpost. Could not tell who caught the two-point conversion.
It was Ziegler.
Ziegler?
Ziegler caught it, yep. Well, the entire Baylor fans have now rushed on the field.
Well, the last time Baylor won was 1985, and I was here to witness that game. It's 20-15.
There go the goalposts.
And that's the ball game. In overtime, Baylor has won it. They went for two. I tell you what, there's no doubt that Sean Bell is the player of the game in this one. 32 for 50, 262 yards, only his third career start, and he looked like a veteran starter tonight.
Well, you said it several times, Dave. He was so cool. He kept his cool, very poised, and never got flustered, was able to find receivers when he needed to. And Baylor has won this one in overtime, 35-34.
Guys, I got to be honest, I never thought I'd live to see it. Never thought I'd see this one.
It's only the second time now that Guy Morris has won a conference game. He beat Colorado here in his first ever conference game, and they lost 11 in a row. I tell you what, give them credit.
Yep,
they did credit. Not quit. And that's a heck of a win for Baylor, and I say congratulations to them. It is a program that has struggled, and tonight, boy, they did all they needed to do. Our broadcast is sponsored by your Texas Dodge dealers. Dodge, grab life by the horns. Aggie fans are still sitting in the stands, stunned by what they just saw. And they are trying now to march the goalpost out of the stadium.
Now, the Baylor fans are trying to figure out what they're supposed to do with the goalpost once they tear them down.
Kind of like that dog that catches the car, huh? All right.
I better be careful. Looks like they're going to drop them over the railing, and I hope nobody is down underneath it.
They're going to take it outside the stadium, apparently. Well, folks, the unthinkable has happened tonight. First time since 1985 that Baylor has been able to beat Texas A&M. And they've done it in overtime, 35-34. And now the Aggies have to get ready for Oklahoma next weekend.